So good morning students, today I am going to explain about reproduction in plant children. So what is reproduction? Reproduction means it is the production of new individuals from their parents. The vegetative parts of the plants are the roots, stem and leaves. The reproductive parts of the plant are the flowers. In plants there are two main types of reproduction. They are asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Let us discuss, children, what is asexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, the new plants without the help of seeds. In sexual reproduction, new plants are produced from seeds. Okay, children, produced from seeds. So asexual reproduction. In plants, there are different types of asexual reproduction. They are vegetative propagation, budding, fragmentation, spore fermentation, etc. So first of all, a vegetative repropagation. In this method, new plants are produced from the vegetative parts like the root, stem or leaves. Example, if the stem cutting of a rose plant or money plant is planted in the soil, we can get a new plant. Potato has a small buds called eyes. If a part of the potato with an eye is cut and planted in the soil, we can get a new plant. If a part of ginger is planted in the soil, we can get a new plant. Bryophyllum has buds in the leaf. If a part of the leaf with the bud is planted in the soil, we can get a new plant. If a part of a cactus plant is planted in the soil, we can get a new plant, children. After the children, here some of the figures, some of the photos of the propagative method: stem cutting of rose, ginger with the new plants, money plant, potato plants sprouting from eyes, bryophyllum leaf with new plants, cactus, etc., children. Budding, second method, budding, children. Example, yeast. In this method, a small projection called bud is formed on the yeast cell. The bud grows and becomes a new yeast cell. The new yeast cell also grows and produces more yeast cells, children. Observe the figure, children, here. Budding in yeast cells. Fragmentation. Spirogyra. In this method, the plant breaks up into two or more fragments, and each fragment grows into new plant, children. Spore formation. Example, fungus, urn, fern, etc. In this method, the fungus produces spores. The spores germinate and produce new plant, children. And observe the figure, children, how a spore formation taking place in the plants. Now, sexual reproduction. Flowers are the productive parts of the plant. Stamen is the male reproductive part and pistil is the female reproductive part. Flowers which have only the stamen or only the pistil are called unisexual flowers, children. Example, mage, papaya, cucumber, etc. Example for unisexual flowers. Flowers which have both the stamen and pistil are called bisexual flowers. Example, rose, mustard, petunia, etc. The stamen has a filament and other anther. The anther contains pollen grains which contain the male gametes. The pistil has sigma, style and ovary. The ovary contains ovules which contain the female gametes or egg. In sexual reproduction, the male and female gametes fuse together to form a zygote, children. Observe the figure, children, how sexual reproduction takes place in the following flowers. Reproductive parts of a flower, children. Observe reproductive organs in the flowering parts: stamens, carpel, section of the stamen, anther, filament, section of carpel, stigma, style, ovary wall, ovule. Pollination. The transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stigma of a flower is called pollination. Pollen grains are transferred by wind, water or insects. If pollen grains lands on the stigma of the same flower, it is called self-pollination. If pollen grains of one flower lands on the stigma of another flower, it is called cross pollination. Observe children, flower 1 and flower 2. Fertilization. The process of fusion of the male and female gametes to form a zygote is called fertilization. The process of fusion of the male and female gametes to form a zygote is called fertilization. After fertilization, the zygote develops into a embryo. The ovule then develops into the seed, and the ovary develops into the fruit. Observe the figure, children. The parts are given here. You can go through it. Seed dispersal. The carrying away of seeds from one place to another is called dispersal of seeds. Seeds are dispersed by wind, water, and animals. Seeds dispersed by wind or light have wings or hair, so that they are easily blown away by wind. Example, drumstick, maple, sunflower, oak, etc. Seeds dispersed by water have spongy or fibrous outer cover so that they can float on water easily. Example, coconut. Seeds dispersed by animals have spines with hooks so that they can attach to the bodies of animals. Example, xanthium. Okay, thank you and have a nice day, children. Okay, observe this one and watch this video and understand the concepts and try to write in your class for children. Thank you and have a nice day.